Step number one, this is the tools or equipment that need to make a film processing. Step two, prepare for your lights out. In this step, you're going to need complete darkness to load the film into the tank. And before you hit the switch, arrange the pieces of your tank where you can easily find them without knocking them into the floor. Once the film is out of its canister, you won't be able to turn the light back on and searching around the floor in black darkness isn't fun. Step 2. Load the film into tank. When the darkness is complete, pry one end of the film canister and take out the roll. It will unravel as you do so, which is fine. As long as your fingers are clean, it's safe to touch the film a little, but try not to handle it too much. Don't let the actual film drag on the floor because you can scratch the emulsion and scrap your pictures clean off. With the film out of the canister, find the leader, the uneven part of the end of the roll of film, and cut it flat across. This snip doesn't have to be perfect, but make sure you don't cut too deep and ruin your first piece. Step 3. Mix the chemical. Be sure to mix the chemicals according to the instructions that come with them. Other chemicals really do mix best at the temperatures under instruction. Use water that's too cold and you might end up with chunks of powder floating around in the bottle, which can get stuck to the negative and ruin them. To keep your negative free of mineral deposits, you should mix them with distilled water. You can get away with tap water if need be. But depending on the mineral content of your water, this might leave spots on your film. Step 4. Develop the film. The first chemical you add is the developer, which makes the actual image crystallize on the film. As soon as you pour the developer in the tank, tap the button of the tank on the counter a few times. This knocks out air bubbles that may have formed around the film and prevents them from leaving ugly spots on the pictures. As time passes, you should agitate the tank for roughly 10 seconds every 30 seconds to a minute.
Doing it more often will give your pictures more contrast and slightly more grain because fresh chemicals will be touching the film on a more regular basis. Although the image should be on the film at this point, it can still be ruined by light.
Step 5. Dry the negatives. The last step in the dev process is hanging the negatives up to dry. You can buy special film clips or just put clothespins on your shower curtain rings like I do. You should keep wet negatives away from dust and animal hair as well as fluctuating temperature.
To prevent the film from curling, take the empty film can you pried open earlier and slide it into the bottom of the film strip.
Step 6. Scan the image.
Once the film is good and dry, you have to get the images of it with a scanner. This process is a lot of work, but once you get up the hang of it, it goes quickly. With a couple double tanks, it can process 2 rolls of film in less than half an hour from turning off the lights to hanging up the negatives to dry.
Just make sure to clean up any chemicals that you spill. Even if they look clear when you're pouring them, they will stain things brown. This is also a really cool excuse to wear a darkroom apron.
Developing preparation. With your tank loaded, move over the sink you will be using and lay out of the chemistry you need in your measured amount. Depending on the developer you will be using, prepare enough chemistry using the recommended dilution on your developer and batter. The tank you are using with dedicated amount of chemistry needed. One important thing to note during this stage is temperature most of the time. It is recommended to work with liquids between 68 to 70 or 20 or 21 Celsius. Use your thermometer to ensure the water you are mixing with developer is this temperature. The procedure consistent and accurate results. If the water temperature is hotter or colder, the film's contrast could be greatly affected and developing times will change.
Now, with your mix developer at 68 Fahrenheit and your mix fixer to the side, you can do an optional but recommended by the author pirouetting stage. Fill the tank loaded with film with 68 Fahrenheit water until it is full and let the film sit for 1 minute. This step brings the film and tank to the temperature of the developer. Can rinse off anti-halation layers and some say it offends the emulsion layer of the film to be more receptive to the developer
the benefits, I'm sure of, it's the temperature stabilization. But it become a habit of mine over the years and has always led to successful results.
After 1 minute, pour the water from your tank down the drain.
Don't worry if the water turns a bright blue, dark purple, or some other colors, that's perfectly normal. And quickly but steadily pour in your mixer developer solution as soon as your tank is full of chemistry. Start your timer and begin agitating the film.
Depending on the tank you are using, various agitation styles can be employed, ranging from total inversion agitation to simply using a spindle to rotate your film. I prefer to use a gentle inversion agitation method. Agitate the film continuously for the first 30 seconds and then agitate for 10 to 15 seconds every 30 seconds. Radifter.
This agitation schedule is pretty standard method. However, it can be changed depending on processing method, developer type, or to alter contrast slightly.
Once you have finished developing, either pour the spent developer down the drain. If you're using one-shot developer, or return the developer to its bottle if it is reusable. Quickly fill your tank with 68 Fahrenheit water, empty it. Fill again with our water and agitate continuously for 30 seconds to 1 minute. This step is functioning as a stopbot to halt the developing action. It is an alternative to using proper stop bulk chemistry. It may practice water has almost always been suitable for stopping developing action, and I've rarely felt that needed to use a true stop bulk. If your total developing time is 5 minutes or shorter, though a proper acetic or citric acid stop bulk can be used to more quickly stop the developing action to prevent over development. After the stop bulk step, empty your tank and fill the tank with your fixer solution. Similar to the developer stage, I like to agitate continuously for the first 30 seconds and then for 10 seconds every 10 seconds thereafter. Fixing typically takes about 5 minutes in total. A minute or so longer won't hurt, but the total amount of time is not as crucial as the development stage. After fixing your film, make sure to return the solution to your bottle using your fixer, dedicated funnel, or graduated, and save.
Now that the fixing is done, you are essentially finished with processing your film and can now remove the lid from your tank. However, I would recommend keeping your film on the rails for the washing process. Many advocate for the use of a hypoclear or washing aid. Step 2. Expedite the total washing time needed. Similar to stop bulk, I feel this step is completely optional if you don't mind spending a few extra minutes washing your film. My process for washing is to fill and empty the tank with cool 68 Fahrenheit water 3 or 4 times, then slow the rate of the faucet and let the water continuously fill and overflow in your tank for approximately 10 minutes. After this rinse period, you can perform one more optional step, and it's time I recommended it, which is the use of wetting agent to prevent water marks from forming on your film during dyeing. After you emptied the tank from the water rinse, refill with the gelate mixed solution of water and wetting agent and let that sit for about 30 seconds or so. Afterward, you can now remove your frills from the tank. Remove your film from the reels and use film clips for hanging your film to dry.
Post-development. After development, let your film air dry in a dust-free area from approximately 2 hours or so until the film is completely dry. If any moisture is still present on the film's surface, just be patient and wait for it to dry as opposed to trying to wipe it off. Once completely dry, I typically cut the film into strips using a pair of scissors and file into negative sleeves.
This is the finished product of a film processing. You can now scan or print the film.